Hello and thanks for watching Proactive. I'm joined by Mark Learmonth. He's the CEO of Caledonia Mining Corporation. Mark, a very good morning to you.
Morning, Stephen.
So Mark, you're up with first quarter results this morning. Can you give us a summary of the quarter?
Yeah, I think the best summary is it was a very challenging quarter for us. Production at Blanket Mine was down from about 18,500 ounces in the first quarter of 2022 to just over 16,000 ounces in this quarter. We had a tiny contribution from Bilboes, pretty much as expected, about 100 ounces from Bilboes, but I think we can talk about that later. So production was down, costs were up. The on-mine cost increased from $700 an ounce to $1,200 an ounce, but a good deal of that was attributable to Bilboes, which perhaps we might talk about later. Bilboes, we effectively spent most of the quarter doing stripping activities and then very small production at the end. So, you know, that had an adverse effect. And then right at the end of the quarter, we had a bit of a cash squeeze as we transitioned our gold sales and export route to, instead of selling to Fidelity in Zimbabwe, we actually started to export it directly ourselves. And that gave rise to a bit of a cash crunch right in the last week or so of the year. So it was a very challenging quarter.
Now take us through the issues that affected production then, Mark.
Yeah, so the issues at Blanket was a series of individually insignificant issues, but collectively they did have an adverse effect. It's also fair to say that quarter one of any year is always a slow build-up as the New Year Christmas break is much more important in the Southern Hemisphere than it is in the Northern Hemisphere. So it does take time for people to get back into their stride. But having said that, you know, we compared Q1 this year to Q1 last year, and it was still disappointing. So the issues, the main issues were really we had two separate failures of the number four shaft winder, which we're still using quite extensively. We had a persistent hang up in the ore pass. So an ore pass is it's a bit like a rubbish chute in a block of flats through which all the ore drops to the bottom of the mine. And then from the bottom of the mine, it's then hauled back up to back to surface. So a persistent hang up in this ore pass, which lasted for I think about a month and a half in total, required us to put in place alternative tramming arrangements underground, which were more expensive, more time consuming, and adversely affected production. Now, having said that, we did see an improvement in April, which was good. And so, but we have now to work hard over the course of the next three quarters of the year to achieve the targets we've set ourselves. At this stage, we're comfortable with our guidance of 75,000 to 80,000 ounces, but we've got a lot of work to do.
You mentioned Bilboes. What impacts did Bilboes activity have on the results?
Yeah, it was always expected that Bilboes would have an adverse effect on our financial performance. And when we gave cost and production guidance at the beginning of the year, we did try and make that clear that by splitting out Bilboes and Blanket and on a combined basis, yes, it was expected that the overall picture would be adversely affected by Bilboes. So effectively, what we've done at Bilboes, we spent about $3.5 million over the course of the first quarter, moving a very large amount of waste material. And it was always intended that we wouldn't see first production until the very end of the quarter, which we did. But having said that, the production that we saw at the end of the quarter was somewhat less than we'd expected. We got 100 ounces, you know, we're expecting a few hundred more than that. But I think more critically, the first target area that we went mining at actually showed a very disappointing grade. And so effectively what it means is now we're having to move to other target areas so to try and maintain production. We've withdrawn production and cost guidance for Bilboes. And our expectation now is that for the remainder of the year, we will continue to run those oxide operations on a basis of on a sort of a break-even basis. Now the reason for doing that is that it does allow us to move large amounts of waste material that we will have to move anyway when it comes to the bigger sulfide project. But more importantly, it also allows us to keep on the books about 150 workers at Bilboes, who we quite like to retain for the purposes of the bigger sulfide project. So that's an inconvenience, but I must just stress that the difficulties we've encountered at the oxide project in no way impinge on the bigger sulfide project, which is the main focus at Bilboes. Again, put it in context, the sulfide project will be producing about 170,000 ounces a year. The oxides was only ever going to produce about sort of 30,000 ounces over the course of a 3-year period. So, you know, the oxides are really irrelevant in the greater scheme of things.
So what are the next milestones for the company then, Mark?
Well, the next milestones are to show Q2 results in mid-July, mid-August, which should show an appreciable improvement in terms of production and cost performance. And then thereafter, try and keep a steady state production and settle operations down before we get down to the serious business, probably about this time next year, of talking about how we're going to commercialize the bigger sulfide project at Bilboes with a view to delivering 170,000 ounces a year.
And the sort of news we can expect from the company over the next 6 months?
Again, it's very much. Hopefully an improvement in performance and then maintaining performance at the target levels for the remainder of the year.
Well, Mark, let's leave it there for today. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you, Steve.
Mark Learmonth, the CEO of Caledonia Mining Corporation.